how about the women? I mean, after the Islamic Revolution in Iran, the women sort of had to cover themselves, abide by certain rules. Do you think those rules are going to start being placed in Iraq?
Well, it has been with some of the militias kind of force women to wear scarves and force the barbers not to cut the beard or whatever. But
they shot some couples with holding hands together or something, the Mahdi army. I read someplace.
Well, the Mahdi
army, in the university or something.
Yeah,
university.
Even the Mahdi army shot some Christians, even.
Right.
But it's in the time of chaos. These things would always happen. It would always happen. But however,
is it happening in Baghdad itself, or is it happening?
It happens in Baghdad. Yeah.
Baghdad
yeah,
as well.
Happens in Baghdad. And this time, the more important things comes first. I mean, I was talking to an American journalist when I was in Baghdad. And I have long hair, and that kind of bring the eyes to me and bring attention to me. So that's why I wear a scarf to cover my hair. So she asked me about women, and do you think that they have to wear scarves in the time of war? And I was like, listen, lady, it's a war zone. I'm a man, and I'm wearing a scarf to protect myself. So if it takes a scarf to protect yourself, do it. Seriously, it's a time of war. It's not a time of negotiations or whatever. But Iraq doesn't have this. I mean, Iraq was always secular.
Always secular.
Yeah.
And do you think, well, I mean, Iran was secular for 50 years.
But
and look what's happening now.
Right,
I mean,
away.
It's completely, it's going the other way. Well, yes and no, because, I mean, there's always conflict between the past and the present and the new and the old and everything. And I think the young people are actually revolting against all the rules. But they are very successful in placing those rules, and people are sort of have to accept it. Do you think that might happen?
I think it might happen in Iraq for a while, and I think after the American army would pull out, there is some uncomfortable situation that's going to happen. But when the big issues has been settled, then Iraqis can say, well, we don't want this dress code. We can choose our own tradition from that point. But yeah, there are going to be uncomfortable situations. You're going to have to not shave your beard or whatever. Though I'm absolutely pro having beards.
You are and you're not. You're a paradox.